Hi everyone, I'm so excited to say that I'm with Emilia at Sancton Wood School and we're going to be bringing Science of Hazel to the lab, so we'll be showing you lots of practicals. Emilia is going to introduce herself.
Hi, my name is Emilia. I am a lab technician. I work in this school, Sancton Wood School in Cambridge. I am also STEM ambassador, which means I go in other schools to introduce science to the kids and we have a lot of fun together. I have also an Instagram page, emilia.science, and follow me to see all my experiments and videos.
Yeah, you should absolutely follow
Thank
her.
You.
Awesome. Hi guys, in today's video, Emilia and I are going to show you how to do the key osmosis experiment, which involves looking at the change in mass of a potato placed in different salt solutions. Now, the crucial thing here is that you understand your variables, because depending on what you change, you can investigate lots of different things relating to the osmosis experiment. The independent variable in this particular experiment will be the concentration of salt solution. So that means that we're going to be changing the solution that the potato is bathed in. Our dependent variable, what we're measuring, will be the change in mass of the potato. And then we'll have several control variables, which we'll discuss throughout the practical. It's really important with this experiment that you understand what osmosis is. Now, osmosis is the net movement of water from an area of high water concentration or high water potential to an area of low water concentration or low water potential across a partially permeable membrane. So what that means is that we expect the potato to either gain or lose mass dependent on the concentration of salt solution that it is placed within. Anyway, that's enough talking. Let's actually start the practical. Crucially, when we make our potato cylinders, make sure as a control variable you're using the same cork borer. That's essential because by altering the surface area, you'll alter the water movement. Notice that the potato cylinders are all coming out of the same potato. Obviously, you might need to use multiple potatoes in order to do the experiment, but make sure they're the same variety. And now we have our three identical cylinders ready to be placed in their various solutions.
Okay, so we have three solutions. One is water, and I'm going to use the cylinder to measure water. Then I have 0.5 molar sodium chloride.
Notice, before anyone comments on Emilia not wearing safety goggles, it's because we're just using salt solutions.
It's not dangerous.
It's not dangerous at all. Perfect, so notice that we have our independent variable, which is what we're changing. So we've got different concentrations of solution. One is pure water, one is 0.5 molar salt solution, one is 1 molar. And notice we have the same volume for each. So that's another control variable. 20 centimeters cubed, and again you need the same temperature as well. Yeah. We're now ready to begin the experiment, so we need to start by measuring the mass of our potato cylinders using a measuring balance. So make sure it reads zero. The first potato chip has a mass of 2.14 grams and we'll place that in the pure water. The second has a mass of 2.19 grams. So notice that although we went to the effort of using the same core borer, cutting them to the same length, they will still have differences in starting mass. So it's essential that you actually record that accurately. And that's going into the 0.5 molar solution. Oh, and then the final potato chip is quite a lot heavier. It's 2.25 grams. And that's going into the 1 molar solution. So now we need to wait for osmosis to occur. Water will either move in or out of the potato based on the water potential or the concentration of water found within the potato. And we're going to measure the mass after 24 hours and see the change. Fast forward 24 hours, we've drained our three potato chips and they're now sitting on the watch glass. Notice that we're going to have to dry them quite carefully using just some normal kitchen paper, and that's in order to remove any excess water so that they can be weighed nice and accurately. So this potato chip was placed in pure water.
2.17.
Yeah, thank you. 2.17 grams, and our starting mass there was 2.14 grams, so our change in mass is 0.03 grams. Our second chip again, sorry, blotting it dry. This was placed in 0.5 molar sodium chloride, so salt solution.
1.64.
Gosh, that's gone down a lot. Its starting mass was 2.19 grams,
yeah.
So a large change in mass there. This floppy sad one is the one that was placed in the strongest salt solution.
1.48.
So our starting mass for that final chip was 2.25 grams, and it's decreased hugely to 1.48. So hopefully you can see in the pure water, it gained in mass, and then in the other two solutions, it lost mass. So in terms of what's happening from a scientific point of view, the chip placed in pure water, well, water entered the chip by osmosis from an area of high water potential, the surrounding solution, to a lower water potential within the chip, and that's why we see that increase in mass. The chip has become turgid. In the salty solutions, water left by osmosis, so the chip became flaccid. Now, you can't just take those changes in masses and be like, okay, right, this is what happened, because it's not a fair test, because we know that our starting mass is slightly varied. So instead, we're going to use a percentage change in mass in order to make a valid comparison. To calculate the percentage change in mass, simply do change in mass divided by the original mass and then times by 100.
Okay, so first one, we gained a 1.4% of gained mass.
Yeah.
Second one, we lose 25% of mass, and third one, we lost 34.2% of mass.
Yeah, and that's literally what we would have expected. Remember, you can draw a graph showing these results, and that will actually help you work out the exact molarity or concentration of salt in the potato chip. So it's a really useful experiment to do.